My grandfather's clock was too big for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weight more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and his pride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, it's life's second numbering. Tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. And in watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many years had he spent as a boy. From childhood to manhood, the clock seemed to know and to share both his grief and his joy. But it struck 24 when he entered through the door with a blooming and beautiful bride. And it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, tick-tock, tick-tock, his life's second numbering. Tick-tock, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. Yes, it stopped short, never to go again, when the